and material design, when you click any button, you will get that ripple effect. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to build this ripple effect when you click any button. As you can see, this is our button, and if you click, you will be able to get that ripple animation exactly at the position that you have clicked. So isn't that beautiful? Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside that, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you will get this HTML5 boilerplate. For the title, I am giving material design ripple click effect using vanilla JavaScript. Now within the body tag, let's create button element. And inside that, I am writing subscribe now. With the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. As you can see, this is the result. There are a few lines of CSS code, so I'm not creating a separate file for our CSS code, okay? Instead, just below the title tag, let's create a style tag. And within that, in order to prevent browser's default margin and padding, for the universal selector, I'm giving margin and padding to 0. And also, for the box sizing, I'm giving border box. Similarly, for the body, let's give minimum height of 100 VH. For the background color, I'm giving this dark blue color. Similarly, in order to bring this button at the center of your browser, I'm using flexbox. Let's give display flex. I'm giving justify content to center. That will bring your button horizontally center. And align item center. That will bring your button vertically center. Now let's style the button. For the bottom, I am giving padding top and bottom to 1 rem. For the left and right, 1.5 rem. Similarly, let's give background image. I am giving linear gradient color. So for the angle, let's give 45 degree. For the first color, I am giving blue. And for the second color, magenta. And also, let's give border radius of 2 rem. And I want to remove that border as well as the outline. So I am giving border and outline none. Similarly, I'm using font shorten property. For the font width, I'm giving 500. For the font size, 1 rem. And for font family, let's give sans serif. Similarly, for text, I'm giving white color. And also, for text transform, let's give uppercase. Within our button, let's create a span tag. So now with the help of that span tag, I'm trying to create the ripple effect. So just wait for a moment. For this span tag, in order to give proper height and width, you can give display block or inline block. So let's give the width and height of 25 rem. Similarly, for the background color, I'm giving white color. And also now let's give position of absolute. As you know, button element, that is the parent of our span tag. So for the button element, let's give position of relative. Now let's bring this span tag exactly at the center of our button. So for that, for the top and left, I'm giving 50%. And for the transform, let's give translate. For the x-axis and y-axis, I'm giving -50%. So now with the help of this code, you'll be able to bring that span tag exactly at the center of your button. Now I want to change this square shape into circular shape. So for that, I'm giving border radius of 50%. And now I'm giving opacity of 0.6. Now let's give the animation. So for the animation name, I'm giving ripple. For the animation duration, I'm giving 1.5 seconds. For the timing function, let's give is. So now let's create keyframes. For the animation name, let's give ripple. Now at 100%, we are going to change this opacity and the transform value. Before that, for the transform, let's add another value, that is scale. So initially for the scale, we'll give 0. And when you reach to 100%, at that time, we'll change it to 1. So let's duplicate the same code and let's take it to that 100%. Now you can change that opacity value to 0. And for the scale, let's give 1. Now you can see that ripple animation. What if I give animation iteration count to infinite? Okay, now you can see that beautiful ripple animation. But as you know, we want that ripple animation when you click that button. So with the help of JavaScript code, we'll create that span tag within our button element. For now, you can remove that span tag. And once again, there are few lines of JavaScript code. So just above the end of body tag, I'm creating script tag. And within that, let's create constant variable button. And I'm assigning document.query selector. So we are selecting the button element. And I am writing button.onClick. So now when you click that button at the time, I am assigning this arrow function along with that E argument. So that E represents the event. Okay. Within that arrow function, let's create variable X. And I am assigning E.ClientX. So that X should be capital, okay. So now with the help of this code, when you click that button, I'm trying to get X coordinate or X position of our mouse. Now in order to track exact position that you have clicked within that button, for that I need to subtract. So I'm writing there minus btn dot offset left. So with the help of this property, you'll be able to get the exact X coordinate of your button that you have clicked. Similarly, now we need to find out Y coordinates. Let's duplicate the same code and just you need to change that X variable to Y and also client X to client Y. And also instead of that offset left, you can give their offset top. With the help of this code, now you will be able to get X as well as the Y coordinates of mouse where you have clicked. As you can see, for this span tag, we have given their top and left value manually. So now we'll change these values with the help of JavaScript code. So you can remove this code. Let's create a span tag. For that, I'm creating constant variable ripple. And I'm assigning document.createElement. So we are creating span element. And if I write ripple.style.css text, and if I assign backtick, in your keyboard just above the tab button or next to number one key, you can find out this symbol. So within our backtick, I'm giving left value for our span tag. You can write their dollar curly bracket. I want to give their X variable, so you can copy and paste that X variable. Just outside of that, you can write px, that means we are giving pixel CSS unit, and let's give their semicolon. Similarly, for the top, we'll give that Y coordinate. And again, we are giving that pixel unit. As you can see, we have created a span tag. Now we need to add that span tag within our button element or something like this. So in order to do that, you can write something like btn.append child. We are appending the span tag. So that is our constant variable ripple. Now when you click button, at the time we are creating span tag and we will place that span tag within our button element that you have clicked. In your browser, did you see that? When I click, look at that. As you know, we have gave ripple animation for that span tag that is within our button element. So you can see that beautiful animation. And now we don't need that animation iteration count. You can remove that. And also you can see when you click that span tag that is overflowing, you know. So for the button element, you can give overflow to hidden. So now you can see when you click your button, we are getting that ripple effect within our button. It seems like everything is done, but there is another problem. So if you inspect this button element, did you see that within our button element, whenever you are clicking your button, at the time we are creating different span tags. In order to prevent that, I can take the help of this setTimeout function. And within that, for the second parameter, you can give the time. So I'm giving there 1500. That means I'm giving 1.5 second. But as you can see, for the ripple animation, I have gave the 1.5 second as animation duration. So I'm giving the same value for our set timeout. For the first parameter, I can give their callback. So I'm giving arrow function. As there is only one line of code, so without using any curly bracket, in the same line, I'm writing ripple dot remove. So with the help of this remove method, now you will be able to remove your span tag from our button element. Now in your browser, did you see that? When I click, after 1.5 second, the span tag that you have given within our button element, that will be removed. So for the last time, let's look at our ripple effect. You can see when I click this button, did you see that our ripple animation takes place exactly at the position that you have clicked. So this is pretty cool. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.